The depiction of the female body came a long way to be presented accurately. Ironically, the earliest known figure representing the human body is that of a female. This figure, known as the Venus of Willendorf, is estimated to be from approximately 40,000 to 16,000 BC. It shows that the woman's body was seen merely as a source of reproduction. The large breast and unproportionately wide hip accentuate the reproductive function of the female body, while the arms, face, and feet can barely be seen. This is the way the female figure was represented for a long time, emphasizing only the reproductive organs absent in men. Bringerio's image of female reproductive organs show a woman with her uterus exposed, which is drawn with bold lines as it is the center of focus. Walter Hermann Ruff's Organs of Generation also has a female figure sitting with her reproductive organs exposed. All the labeling is restricted to this area. Simon de Colleen's figure of the female shows her reproductive organs with her skin rolled up at the bottom like a scroll. It can be noticed that only the reproductive organs were taken care of for accuracy. In P.B. Corton's image, the female is holding her skin open to expose her reproductive tissue with the tiny fetus inside. The female body sometimes acted as a symbolic figure connecting life and death. In Versalius' De Humani Corpori, death, represented as a skeleton, is standing right behind the female corpse, while men, representing life, stand around. In Ivo Seliger's painting, this is more explicitly represented as the female body stands between the male surgeon, representing life, and the skeleton, showing death. It was believed that the sight of the female body would provoke fear of castration and death in young boys, but it was also the female body that gives life to them. Medical illustration on female reproductive organs became more accurate during the 18th century. However, as the illustration became more realistic, they were scrutinized as being sexual or pornographic in nature. When John Joseph Stockdale published his 18 plates of male and female genitalia in 1827, people saw them as pornography and called them disgusting, rather than applauding the accuracy of these images. Publishers fought to declare that the plates were expected to educate medical concepts, rather than act as purely sexual or seductive in content. Despite the scrutiny, anatomists like Jan van Rimsdijk continued to produce more realistic and more accurate images on the female reproductive organs. Femininity often is associated with blossoming flowers and ripening fruits. Female reproductive organs also have received botanical representation in many medical illustrations. The woman's womb was often symbolized as a blossoming flower. In this Valentine card, printed during the 1850s, a pink-colored rose replaces the woman altogether as a baby sits within. Thumbelina was a popular fictional character created by Hans Christian Andersen, who is born out of a blossoming tulip. This concept of the female reproductive organ as blossoming vegetation was used by Odoardo Fialetti in 1631 as well, in Adrian van de Spiegel's De Forma Fuidu. In this engraving, the placenta, umbilical cord, and the infant's position is relatively accurate, whereas the woman's skin tissue is flayed, open like a flower. It is clear that the woman's body was portrayed merely as a beautiful embodiment of the fetus. The skin above the fetus, open like flower petals, is a recurring theme in female illustrations. Gerard de Lares also shows the fetus in the mother's womb, but the female's face is completely cut off from this scene. Ruff's inaccurate depiction of the reproductive organs resembles an upside-down tree, with the ovaries hanging off like blackberries or a flower blossom. The image of a fetus from De Forma Fuidu looks like a lily or daffodil in full blossom, holding the fetus inside. In 1890, Dr. Samuel Jean Posey published a book called Traite de Gynécologie Clinique et Opérato, which made a significant influence in the field of gynecology. Although the female reproductive organ figures in his text were less explicit in their similarity to botanical specimen, some of the figures have a clear influence from the stylization. These figures in Posey's book show a myosarcoma of the cervix and fibrous adenoma of the uterus has a striking similarity to a cluster of grapes. Charles Nicolet's culpeperineoplasty by flap splitting and suture of the abdominal walls about the pedicle resemble a slipper orchid blossom. The carefully arranged pubic hair depicts the hairy lip of the orchid, while the sheet above the abdominal organ is flayed laterally, like the sepals of the orchid. Tarnier's simple vegetations of the vulva displays lichenous plant budding across the vaginal area and in the inner thighs, like moss and wild vegetation growing at the entrance to a cave. This subtle imagery of female reproductive organs as botanical species was not unique to Posey's book. In J. Blandell Sutton's book, Disease of the Ovaries, the ovarian dermoid containing epithelial balls resembles a sectioned pomegranate. In the same book, Dayett's engraving shows a 17-year-old girl with a giant ovarian cyst. The large expanded stomach resembles a cabbage or an Asian pear, blankets distributed around like leaflets surrounding the fruit. Another popular imagery used with female reproductive organs was that of polyps. Savage's engraving of the transverse section of the female pelvic floor shows the frilled fallopian tubes and wormy intestines, like the ocean floor, filled with coral reefs and polyps. Because the female and the male bodies are parallel in many ways, the female body has only been represented by its unique reproductive organs. Due to this depiction, the female body has been associated with concepts such as giving life, castration, sex, and floral beauty. It is very important to continue the study of the female body and to understand it, as it is the place where all mankind begin their journey of life. Thank you.